James Corden and Tiny Temper will be here soon. First, though, he's the rising star who made Spielberg swoon, wowed Woody Allen, and made me go four in four. Give it up for Tom Hiddleston! Right, welcome to Chatty Man.
Thank you very much. Thank you. It's a great pleasure to be here.
I heard you actually watch Chatty Man at home.
I do watch Chatty Man at home.
I'm a big fan. Dream come true for you.
It is.
Like you're pinching yourself.
I am a bit. And it's a bit surreal because, you know, I sort of tend to mouth along with you sometimes when I'm watching, you know, sort of.
Really?
When I see the trailer on the night before. Join me, Alan Carr, at 10 tomorrow night. I'm treading a Hollywood. What a week it's been.
Oh my God. You have seen the show.
I have seen the show, yes.
We've got to talk about your new film.
Yes, let's do
that.
Sure.
The Dark World.
Yeah.
I loved it.
Thank you very much. It's brilliant. Yeah.
I didn't understand what was going on, but I loved it.
Yeah, it's bonkers.
Yeah.
But it's good.
It's so great.
It's out tonight in cinemas.
I'm getting my head round it. You play Thor's brother, Loki.
Yep.
That's right, isn't it?
Yep.
In that Avengers film, he tried to take over New York.
Yes.
But that went tits up. Uh-huh. And Loki was then banged up.
In a manner of speaking.
Yes. But in this film, it's all kicking off in Asgard.
It certainly is.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And you and Thor now have to get together to save it.
That's it.
There you go.
Very good.
Now, I remember Thor from school.
Yeah.
And it never had spaceships. No, it didn't.
Yeah.
Did all that come from the comics?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because I read about, you know, your character Loki.
Yeah.
Didn't he have sex with a horse and gave birth? No, gave birth to an eight-legged horse.
Yeah, so no ordinary horse.
No.
Yeah.
I was looking for that. But we're going to see that. Honestly, I was looking for it.
It's a reasonable expectation, Alan.
Yeah.
I mean, if it's in the mythology, why is it not in the movie?
Exactly.
My response to that is it's, you know, a sort of child-friendly film.
What's wrong with an eight-legged horse? Kids love ponies, don't they? It just looked like a deformed pony.
You know, maybe in the next one. I'll pitch it.
Have you got that much power? Could I have a part in it? I know this is really cheesy, but...
Would you like to play the eight-legged horse?
I just want to be in the movies. I'll even play one of the legs. I don't...
Or you could be like the front end. I suppose because you wouldn't have to see whoever's playing the back end. I could play the back end.
Yes.
If you'll pardon the expression. I have created a monster.
Yes. Let me just have a think about that for a minute.
Have a think about.
Well, we've got a clip now. This is Thor and Loki joining forces to save Asgard in Thor, the Dark World.
I know you seek vengeance as much as I do. You helped me escape Asgard, and I will grant it to you. Vengeance. And afterward, this cell.
You must be truly desperate to come to me for help. What makes you think you can trust me?
I don't. And you should know that when we fought each other in the past, I did so with a glimmer of hope that my brother was still in there somewhere. That hope no longer exists to protect you. You betray me, and I will kill you.
When do we start?
Thank Ford, played by Chris Hemsworth.
Yes.
He's huge.
He's huge.
Look at that.
There he is.
It's like Paris Hilton on steroids. And what's that hammer like? Is it proper heavy?
It is quite heavy. Yeah, I mean, it's not as heavy as it should be.
No.
Otherwise, slightly impractical for filming.
Yes.
You know, he's the only person who can move. It wouldn't be easy. Yet. So, there are different weights. So, when he's doing a particularly complicated stunt, there's one he can swing about. And then there's when he sort of wants to hold it and feel like the mighty Thor. It's got a bit of heft to it. I love that hammer. There are some very cool things he does with it, too.
Yeah, he does. Come on. You know what? All of you, go out, have a shower, come back, and we'll continue, OK? Because he's mentioning hammer, and you're going, oh, yeah, hammer. It's Thor, he's got a bloody hammer. That's his weapon.
I'll just be definitive on the subject.
Yeah.
Thor has a big magic hammer. And he knows how to swing it.
Yeah.
I wonder if it's time to have a pretzel.
Because you originally auditioned for Thor, didn't you?
Yeah.
No offence, but I mean, you look at... shut up. I've seen bigger lumps in muesli. can you physically get as big as him, like with the old weights and stuff, you know, and eating all the food? Could you?
I mean, what happened initially was there's a whole bunch of us who auditioned for the film, and of course we all auditioned to play Thor, and so I did when I screen tested, I put on about 20 pounds of muscle, which is about the heaviest I've ever been. It's not my natural genetic inheritance, shall we say?
Yeah.
But I'm all right with that.
No.
You know, I think it all worked out for the best. You know, Loki's a great part.
He is a great part.
It's a great part.
He's got sense of humour. You get the best lines.
He's the god of mischief.
Yeah.
Thor's the god of thunder. Loki's the god of mischief. It's my job to turn up on set and have a great time.
Do you ever Google yourself? I call it master Googling. Do you ever do that?
No.
No.
I try to stay well away.
Well, it's in... don't.
Okay, good.
Because I put your name in. My God, the fan stuff and the online, it's so... The stuff that people talk about you, it's so twisted.
This is probably why I stay away.
They do drawings of you. This is what Loki would be if he was a single mum. Why would he... I'm not making this up. I'm not making this up.
That's amazing. I've never seen that before in my life.
There's a lot of drawings of Loki pole dancing. This is another one.
Wow. Yeah, I knew about the pole dancing.
Yeah, because that's in the first one, isn't it? You put the
that's
thing
it. There's
in.
A thing, and I've been the third. So I try to spear him, and he dodges out the way, and the spear goes in the ground, and then I leave around, jump in midair, and kick him in the chest. And
but no way are you wearing prostitute shoes.
I'm not. No.
And I can't show you the next one as this is a family show, but whoever did it, that really. Whoever did it obviously has got talent. Look. Oh. I mean, that's... Whoever did that obviously watched Chatty Man, cos I got one the other day.
You did?
I did. This is me and David Dickinson.
Oh. OK. Wow. Wow.
I mean, that's just...
Yes. I feel like we're somehow bonded by this. I just feel closer to you.
Honestly.
I just feel immediately closer to you. If you ever want to talk,
just So sorry about that.
Chris Hemsworth and I call it therapy.
Therapy? Anyway, good luck with Thor.
Thank you.
And you're going to come back at the end. We're going to have a little chat with Tiny and
I can't James. Wait. You're big fans of both of those people.
Oh, yep. Yep. We'll stay right there.
Thank you very much.
Tom Hiddleston, everyone! After the break, James Corden and Tiny Temper will be here. See you in part three. Welcome back to part four. Look who's still here. It's only James Bloom and Corden. And look who else is here. It's only Tom Hiddleston and Tiny Blinking Temper. Do you all know each other?
Yes.
We do.
And we do. Yeah.
Yeah.
Separately, but
this is the first. It's a great pleasure.
Yeah, likewise, man.
Oh, nice.
This is the boss, man. This is on the boss. This is on the silver screen.
Hey, didn't we have a great time at my wedding? Hey, guys. We just had a great time. We had a great time.
I never got invited to that, man. No, but
hey, you stop.
Yes, honey. Did it hurt? Doesn't it hurt?
You never got invited either.
No.
I thought you'd come with me on that.
No, man.
No, you say yes.
No
thank
way.
You.
No, we got beef for that, man.
Okay, how are you doing, love?
I'm really good. Yeah, really, really good. Just happy to be back. I'm in good spirit. The album's coming out on Monday, so I'm really, really happy. Demonstration, finally.
Why is it taking you ages?
It has taken me ages because, as you guys both know, being creative people, you can't rush these things, you know? You can't. You really can't.
And I would know what it's like to be creative.
Sorry.
This show today has just been one big kick in the teeth.
No, but I had to get it right. And, you know, there's so many exciting people I got to work with on it, from Emily Sandé and Laura and Vula and Dizzy Rascal.
I love Laura.
2 Chainz and Labyrinth and Big Sean. So getting all those people together, you know, time and place, it took ages. But I'm happy. It's ready to go.
They're amazing people.
Yeah.
I can't wait to hear it.
And, yeah, James, did you meet Jay-Z recently?
You know, I did, yeah. Yeah, I know. No, it wasn't cool. I just lost it. I lost my shit. It was not. I think I'm normally all right. And then I went to this thing, and it ended up that it was just about 4 of us in this room in New York. And he said, "Hey man, how's it going?" And all I could say was, "Yeah, I've got that suit." and he went like this. He went, "Cool, man." And then I just went.
It's an amazing thing being starstruck, isn't it? You just don't know what to do.
Yeah.
I mean, the last time it happened to me, I was I met Boris Becker at Wimbledon.
I met Boris Becker the other day.
I met him in a cupboard at a Japanese restaurant.
Zing.
Big mistake.
But is it true? Didn't you get starstruck with a Muppet?
I did, yep. I have a very, very small part in the new Muppets film. And I was in costume on stage. The director was like, "You ready, Tom?" "Absolutely, let's go." There's a curtain in front of me on stage. And suddenly there's a drum roll and a spotlight. And the sound of Kermit the Frog. "Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome." And I thought, it's Kermit the Frog. And then the curtains opened and I went, "I'm really sorry, I don't know what I'm supposed to do. I forgot what I'm supposed to..." It's just Kermit.
Kermit.
Yeah, I was just a bit starstruck. And they were all very sweet. And "Oh my God, so unprofessional."
we're all performers and, you know, just get on with the show.
I'm thinking there. You know, your different voices and stuff. We were talking about boy bands, weren't we?
Yeah.
And of putting one together, you know, because it used to be an Insatiable, also known as Full Frontal.
Tiny nose.
And I mean, would you like to audition to be in our... Is it our boy band? I'm actually...
Is it happening tonight? This is a new boy band.
For one night only, Full Frontal.
Musically, who I'd like to be is Tiny's guy on stage who says the other words.
Because
that's that's what I like to be. No, like, so you go do your I'll be there, they go, hello, say hola, and they say
They say hello, they say hola, and they say
bonjour.
Nah, nah,
nah. Keep going. Go on.
And please, I never got to fly on a
Concorde.
African crazy with their kicks, school me.
Jean-Claude.
My God, that's amazing.
That's who I'd like to be. I'd like to be that guy. Do you pay him by the word?
Yeah, we pay him literally by the word. By the word, so whenever you're ready.
Yeah.
Maybe you two could sing. Could we dance?
Let's dance.
This would be good.
Can we dance? What music have we got?
No, let's get a clap from everybody.
Anyway, we've just watched the next James Bond.
That's the bag of it.
Damn straight.
Honey, you're going to perform me in a minute. You go and get ready. Tiny Temper's going to perform for us. Oh, thank you so much, Tiny Temper, everyone.
Good luck, everybody.
That's it for tonight's show. I know, I've had so much fun. It's a massive thank you to Joan Collins, Tom Hiddleston, and of course James Corden. On next week's show, I'll be joined by Jack and Michael Whitehall, Robin Thicke, and Paul O'Grady. But now with Children of the Sun, it's Tiny Temper!